it comes to preventing impact-related injuries, like long bone injuries in running, it's important to stress that a lot of research shows that forefoot running has an impressive record of producing better results than heel strike running. This is because forefoot strike running produces only a very narrow set of impact forces that are more easily tolerated by the musculoskeletal system. And this is because when you run with a forefoot strike, the forefoot to heel movement path of the foot in forefoot running not only enables the landing foot to swiftly glide onto the ground with very minimal jarring force, very minimal jerk force, and a next to none hard hitting collision force, landing with a forefoot strike during running also naturally brings into line safer mechanics, such as reduced stride length and increased step rate or cadence, which is the number of steps per minute. Altogether, these are the mechanical outputs that are study proven to be very impact protective and linked to better outcomes in preventing impact-related injuries. Confirmation of the safeguarding effects of forefoot strike running on the body as compared with heel strike running comes from a 2019 report in the Journal of Sport and Health Science, which found that switching from heel strike running to forefoot strike running may have the most positive influence on reducing injurious impact loads as compared with increasing run cadence while running with a heel strike, because even though increasing run cadence has been shown to reduce impact, the researchers discovered that increased cadence while heel strike running still produced more damaging impact variables than forefoot strike running, suggesting that the real potential for a heel strike runner to have a better shot at avoiding an impact-related injury is to switch to forefoot strike running rather than increasing cadence while remaining a heel strike runner. The study, which is linked down below in the description box, compared the intensity of certain impact force variables and the short and long-term biomechanical effects between increased run cadence while heel strike running and the adoption of a forefoot strike running style in heel strike runners. Specifically, the study involved 39 healthy recreational runners who were habitual heel strike runners and ran with a low cadence. The runners were randomized into two groups. The first group was the cadence retraining group. In this group, the heel strike runners weren't asked to change their foot strike. They were told to retain their heel strike running style, but were asked to run with a 7.5% increase in their cadence. The second group was the forefoot running group. Now, this group was asked to switch their heel strike to a forefoot strike landing pattern during running. All runners performed 4 weeks of strength training, followed by 8 sessions of gait retraining using auditory feedback. I want to also mention and emphasize that the forefoot running group was provided with zero drop, completely flat, and very thin minimalist running shoes, the Innovate Barracks F210. Of which my review on those minimalist shoes is linked down below in the description box. The forefoot running group was asked to wear these shoes as part of the intervention because the lack of underheel cushioning or the complete flatness of the shoe's design enables this type of shoe, a flat minimalist shoe, to help promote a forefoot strike landing with greater ease during running, as landing heel first or heel striking without any underheel padding during running is discomforting. And because of this, you have a natural reflexive tendency to avoid that discomfort by landing further away from the heel, making initial ground contact on the forefoot or on the balls of the foot, as doing so instantly feels more natural because it feels more comfortable. And this is because the forefoot acts as a better shock pad than the heel in the absence of underfoot cushioning during running, partly because there's more surface area on the forefoot for effective impact dispersal. So at no point does a peak pressure form because there's no pressure forces becoming overdense and localized to one small area of the foot in forefoot running as compared with heel strike running, whereby at heel strike, because surface area is very small at the initial ground contact point on the heel, causes peak force pressure to shoot up and remain hyperlocalized to that one small area of the foot, which is the heel, which in turn can very easily produce greater peak force pressure levels in excess to the area, creating an injurious hot spot on the heel, and is one of the reasons heel pain and heel injury are very common in heel strike runners, despite running in shoes with very thick padded heels. And getting back to the study, the cadence retraining heel strike running group increased their preferred run cadence by 7.5% with the use of auditory feedback via a metronome. Now, like the forefoot running group, the cadence retraining heel strike running group was provided with footwear but conventional neutral cushioned running shoes, the Innovate Roadclaw 275. They were assigned this type of shoe because the runners were not instructed to change their heel strike landing during running, so therefore, under heel protection was very essential because making initial ground contact on the heel during running has been repeatedly proven to generate significantly more impact then landing forefoot first while running. Also keep in mind that run cadence can be increased without changing foot strike pattern, which is what was observed in the current study. The researchers then compared the effects of these gait retraining parameters on the production of the impact force variables and vertical loads closely tied to causing most common running related injuries. Their analysis showed a very strong relationship between forefoot striking during running and a significant reduction in vertical average load rates and vertical instantaneous load rates. And there's a long-standing position among many experts that these two impact variables, by many estimates, probably underlie most running-related injuries. More specifically, their data showed that the forefoot running group demonstrated a near 50% reduction in overall distressing impact loads. And most exciting, the forefoot running group also showed a 41.7% reduction in the vertical average load rate and the vertical instantaneous load rate, respectively, at the 1 month follow-up, suggesting that forefoot running may sustain well at being a better long-term solution at giving you more protective means to avoid high impacts, as well as giving you a better shot at potentially avoiding impact-related injury. So how come when the heel strike runners switched to forefoot running, they showed these stark reductions in harmful impact loads with forefoot running and barefoot-like running shoes? The researchers detailed that most directly responsible for the reductions in these impact force variables in forefoot running in minimalist shoes was partly due to the activation of the calf musculature, which increased the deceleration time of the vertical velocity after ground contact. Put another way, the calves acted as a natural shock absorber and ankle stabilizer after the forefoot made initial ground contact, of which after initial ground contact is made on the forefoot, shown in picture 1, the heel drops down to the ground, as shown in pictures 2 to 3, which resulted in an uptick in muscular activation in the calves because the calves in this capacity play a key role in not only effectuating shock absorption, but in creating a stronger, more stable foot-ground connection. Fundamentally, one of the core reasons landing with the forefoot strike works so well to help against dangerous rises in impact during running is because of the forefoot-to-heel movement path of the foot, shown here from 1 to 3. In conjunction with the help of the calves locking in stronger ankle stability, as well as helping diffuse impact more fully, thereby preventing the spread of heavy impact loads on the leg. And this landing configuration in its entirety, along with the securing, engaging, and impact-absorbing activity of the calves, enables the landing foot to swiftly glide onto the ground and interact with the ground with minimal jarring force and impact amplification. This is how pounding of the feet is reduced, as well as damaging rises in impact loads in forefoot running. What is more, as I mentioned earlier, forefoot running naturally brings on board additional mechanical outputs such as a higher cadence and a reduced stride length These mechanical outputs are shown to be very low impact, which was also observed in the study in that the forefoot running group showed a higher cadence and a shortened stride, which is in accordance to other assessments also showing increased run cadence naturally brings into line a shorter stride, which has been factually proven to significantly reduce the flow of high impact loading. That's a very key point to remember, is that when you run with a forefoot strike, it closes off a lot of high impact pathways by naturally prompting a higher cadence and a shorter stride. This is because, as the researchers went on to describe, that when you make initial ground contact on the front part of your foot during running, it naturally makes the foot more well-positioned to land closer to your center of mass at touchdown, thus keeping stride length within a very short, safe range, and also has the direct effect of naturally increasing cadence, which taken together are chief components in preventing higher rates of loading on the leg, mainly because a higher cadence and a shortened stride length via forefoot strike during running
does not produce an abrupt yet heavy spike in impact at touchdown. Rather, there's a complete elimination of an impact spike peak at touchdown as indicated by a smooth curve as shown in graph B, which overall shows the impact generation at touchdown in forefoot running. So in forefoot running, you don't get that initial rapid spike in impact that's produced when you make initial ground contact on the back of the foot or on the heel during running, which is shown in graph A, because the action of landing heel first during running may open up your stride a little too much in front of your center of mass, pushing your foot to land outside the tolerable range of low impact. And so at touchdown, at heel strike, a strong spike in impact is immediately produced on account of the heavy collision force or brake force that's distinctly and uniquely produced when you heel strike with an overextended stride while running, and may ultimately make you more resistant to efforts in improving injury prevention outcomes.
Now, did the cadence retraining heel strike running group experience the same big reductions in impact loading as the forefoot running group? Unlike the forefoot running group, which had very positive outcomes in impact reductions, the cadence retraining heel strike running group demonstrated very minor reductions in impact load rates with only a 14.7% reduction in vertical average loading rate and only a 9% reduction in the vertical instantaneous loading rate that also did not reach significance in the short term, suggesting that based on these findings, when it comes to running with less overall impact, you're just better off converting your heel strike to a forefoot strike during running in minimalist shoes rather than increasing your cadence and efforts to lighten the landing load while remaining a heel strike runner through the use of cushion-heeled running shoes. Overall, these findings fit into a continuum of complementary findings, compellingly showing that foot strike pattern directly affects other mechanical parameters, specifically such as cadence and stride length, which in turn most directly affect impact production and ultimately reminds about how important foot strike pattern may be in injury prevention in runners. Awareness of these findings also makes it clear that forefoot runners may be far less likely to overstride and pound the feet into the ground, and therefore may be more likely to leave impact-related injuries behind as compared with heel strike runners. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the like button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already to stay updated on all the latest research regarding forefoot versus heel strike running and barefoot versus shod or shoe running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.